In today's tutorial, we're going to be talking about the customization settings in Zoho Marketing Automation so you know how to customize it exactly to your needs. So let's log in and I'll see you there. All right, now that we're logged in, let's check out our settings tab and go through the customization settings this time. So again, on the bottom left, click your settings tab, and then you can see we have these customization options over here. So we have the header and footer, signup pages and emails, custom fields, and merge tags that we can go through and customize. So let's first start with the header and footer. We can go through and change this. We can change the theme of it, which is quite nice, or we can use other themes. Now, there are no other themes to display here, but we can create different themes, and this would be the way to do that. So we can create our first theme by going through here and setting this up. We can change all these images and things like that as well and make it look a lot nicer. So this is just one way to go through it. I recommend this as it allows you to be a bit more content and brand oriented when it comes to sending out your email. So this is helpful if you go through that as well. Then you just don't have to worry about creating the header and footer and they're just automatically there. So that's what I recommend just to stay a bit more on brand. So if we go back now to the settings tab and go to signup pages and emails, we can have a few more options here. We see our landing pages, our confirmation pages, our notification emails, our forms, and our thank you pages. So now that we've gone to this page, we can see that we have our signup pages and emails that we can go through and customize. So our landing pages, so for example, update your profile. Click the button below to receive the email via which you can update your profile. So there's one way to go through that. That would be the landing page. That's what it looks like. We can go through the confirmation pages. So this is the updating your profile. We've sent the link to update your profile via email. Please check your inbox. Then we have the notification email. So this is what they would see when they go through that process. And then here's a form. This is what the form would look like when they're going through all of that. So please update your details here. So lead email, first name, last name, so you can update this. So you can change this so it doesn't say lead email, for example, because that may not leave the best taste in your user's mouth. So let's just say email instead of lead email. That way it's just being mapped correctly. And then we could just save that and we can get out of here. So that looks a little bit better. So we're just going to close that. So that's how your contacts would go about updating their information. And then the last thing is the thank you page after they have updated. So this is all just to make sure that they've updated their information correctly. Most people don't really worry about this because most people don't have information they need to update. But if your clients do, if your customers do, then this is how they'd go about doing it. So you want to make sure that these emails are branded properly to your branding and your colors just to make it stick a little bit more and they are having a good experience and they're not thinking, oh my goodness, what the heck did I get myself into? So that is how you go about updating that. And we also have the custom fields option over here as well. So this is where you can create your custom fields. We've done this before. We've come to this setting before in one of the other tutorials. So you can go through and add this to both your product audience and product data fields as custom fields too. And so this is where you go to check out and set up the custom fields that you've created. And from there, we can check out the last item, which is a merge tags. Now we haven't really talked too much about this yet, but we have a different merge tags we can add in here. And these merge tags are actually variables that you can use in your system. So you can actually create some new merge tags, which this can be pretty important. So I don't want to gloss over this briefly. So you have these different icons you can even create for Facebook, Twitter, and Pinterest. You can create different merge tags for basically anything in here. You can create video tags and things like that. So this is actually super important. And I highly recommend you taking a moment to look at it and see if you can utilize it because we can create a new custom tag. So let's, for example, let's create a video tag. We want to send out maybe a most recent video to our users, or maybe you want to send out a video that has a ton of value for our contact list or our lead list that we think could be beneficial. So this is a great way to go about creating that. And then we also have the ability to create custom lead tags. So our merge tag here, we could set it up to be clientric. I'm just going to close that out. And this is what it would look like. I think I actually just need to get rid of that. And then we can change the field. So this would relate to a specific field. Let's just say it's a mobile number. This is the tag we'd want to use for that one. And then the default value would be, let's just say test. And then the social default value would be, let's say test social. So this is what it would look like when we use it. So it's really important and it actually can be pretty beneficial if you have variables you want to include moving forward on custom fields and things like that. That would be huge. So make sure you take a look at this and just understand how to use it, what you can do with it. And then from there, you can make the most use out of it and set your system up so you're set for success. As always, we hope that's been helpful. Make sure that you subscribe to our channel below, like our videos, and comment on our videos. We want to make sure this content is getting out to everyone that needs it. And feel free to join our Facebook and Instagram channels. We're growing our community like crazy right now. We want to make sure that you're involved with it too. So that'd be a great place to connect with us and getting the most value you possibly can. We look forward to seeing you in our next tutorial. Bye for now.